stadium has been known for years as Death Valley. And the LSU Tigers have buried team after team in the Bayou Swamps. In fact, the Gamecocks haven't won an LSU in 8 tries. However, South Carolina has been rolling. You better make that running. It's a double dose of Gamecock backfield attack. And that has put the Gamecocks in a position to get another road victory. It's an important SEC matchup. South Carolina, LSU, next on Video Seat. Of a monsoon in the heart of the bayou in the state of Louisiana. Tonight, an SEC battle, the South Carolina Gamecocks and the LSU Tigers. Hello, everybody. Jim Brinson, along with my tag team partner, Brad Edwards, of course, the former Gamecock, former Minnesota Viking, and also former Washington Redskin. This guy's looking for a job. If you know anybody, you could. In all reality, we know. I know that. I know you do. In all reality, we know what happened to LSU 2 weeks ago. Can LSU come back and be a good football team tonight?
Absolutely. I think what we're looking at here is an LSU team that could very easily be undefeated. They lost a squeaker of a game to Texas A&M, lost a tough game at Auburn last week. It went all the way down to the fourth quarter, had some interceptions, some turnovers, but they could very easily come away with this game.
All right, let's talk then about some of the individuals which we're going to focus on this evening, beginning first with the LSU Tiger QB, Jamie Howard.
Yeah, this guy's playing really well. He had maybe one letdown, and that was against Auburn, obviously, last week. Had 5 interceptions in the fourth quarter. He can't do that tonight.
All right, let's move to the defensive side of the ball, and Mike Collet.
Mike Collet is playing really well. This guy's the team's second leading tackler, and it's going to be really important tonight that he play well between the tackles.
And of course, everybody is well aware of what happened at Auburn. The Tigers had Auburn on the ropes, and then that disastrous second half set in. In fact, Auburn goes on to win the game. They did not score a touchdown with their offensive unit. Truly amazing. For South Carolina, they are 3-1. They have won 3 straight games, and one of the reasons is the play of Steve Tannehill.
Yeah, here's another guy who's playing very well. He's playing just in the confines of Brad Scott's offense here. He's not turning the ball over. He's really playing well.
All right, defensively now, Stacey Evans is going to have to be a big-time player in the middle tonight.
Here's another guy who's SEC Player of the Week against Arkansas. Had a huge game. He's going to have to play well tonight because I think the running game is going to be really big tonight.
All right, and of course, in the defensive secondary, Reggie Richardson had that double interception game against Kentucky last weekend.
Yeah, Reggie is leading the SEC in interceptions with 3, had 2 big plays last night. It's going to be important that he play well tonight as well.
All right, now for South Carolina and LSU, this is a confrontation between these two teams where the Gamecocks have not been able to win here in 8 opportunities.
The Gamecocks face off against Louisiana State this week, looking for a 4th straight win and 2 straight road victories. Meanwhile, the Tigers are hoping to regroup. LSU literally threw the game away 2 weeks ago against Auburn, lobbing 3 interceptions in the 4th quarter. That collapse aside, Carolina expects a major challenge from the Tigers.
The biggest difference I see on their team over what they did last year is they just seem to have turned them loose a little bit more on defense. And they're very aggressive. They're an upfield. It's another 4-3 defensive team. But they are a penetrating attack football team.
I think that they've had 2 weeks off to prepare, and, you know, I don't think our offense played that well this week. Our offensive line, you know, me included, we made a lot of mistakes, and we're far from being as good as we should be. And, you know, any team that has 2 weeks to get ready and, you know, 2 weeks to prepare some of the things for us, they're dangerous.
Tonight, the Gamecocks find themselves on the road again. This time it's Baton Rouge, where visitors constantly get into trouble.
That's always tough to play on the road, but I hope we could approach it and have the same attitude that we would have playing here at home. Obviously, we won't have the same amount of fans and the type of support we have here, but you got to be able to play tough wherever you go.
Leading Carolina in the quest for USC's first ever win in Tiger Stadium, SEC Offensive Player of the Week Steve Tannehill. Tannehill completed 25 of 38 passes on his way to earning the honor, and his improved play this season is turning heads on his own team.
I can tell you the thing that has that's very obvious to me that I'm most impressed with from where we started, that fundamentally he's not even the same young man. His faking, his ball handling, his attention to the detail out there has improved tremendously.
He's completely different. Oh, it's night and day than the way it was in the past. His ego is gone. He's down to earth now, and he listens. He's coachable, I think. You know, he listens to what they're telling him, and because he knows they're going to make him better. And it's obvious the way he's playing that he's different. You know, when you don't see his helmet pop off, and you don't see him, you know, some of the things he used to do. I think, you know, you can live with the kid now.
Something else the Gamecocks can live with: more victories and the novelty of year-end bowl possibilities.
Obviously, you know, the questions are out there, and that's always been presented. I think our players, you know, they understand what it takes to get in a bowl and what's going to happen, but we can't solve that problem tomorrow. You know, that's not a thing. Every game we play is important to us, but, you know, we've only played 4 ball games, and we've got 7 regular season ball games left to go.
Previewing South Carolina, I'm Mark Bryant.
Well, we've already indicated to you on how bad the weather is. Right now, we're going to take you down onto the field. Please, somebody throw Todd Ellis a raft, will you? Todd, are you okay down there, buddy?
Thanks, guys. As obviously, the biggest story that's developing right now is developing right in front of us, and it's the weather here. 70% chance of showers throughout the night. And we're at sea level here, so obviously Baton Rouge doesn't do too well in the rain. We've looked at the field already. These guys chewed it up pretty good during warm-ups. That will be a factor. I've got to believe that that's an advantage to Carolina because they have 2 big running backs in Brandon Bennett and Stanley Pritchett. LSU has a lot of offensive weapons, but not the big pounding backs that Carolina has. The other key to this ball game is early success. Auburn had a lot to do with the emotion of this football team at LSU coming out tonight. Carolina knows that they've got to create some good things early in this ball game to take the crowd that's here out of it and to make LSU feel like nothing can go right during this season. We'll keep you updated from the sidelines. Let's go back upstairs.
All right, Todd, thank you very much. Right now, we're going to check out some of the keys that we think will be important in tonight's game. Let's check them out for you right here. Beginning first for LSU, the keys to the game here, Brad.
Yeah, LSU, it's going to be vitally important that they be able to convert on third down this week. Cannot turn the ball over like last week. 5 fourth quarter interceptions, 3 of them returned for touchdowns. Something they've been doing very well this year, playing great on special teams. Eddie Kinnison having a tremendous year returning punts.
All right, now for South Carolina and what they have to do to have an opportunity to get the W.
Obviously, with the rain, it's going to be vitally important that they run the ball and control the ball, control the clock. They're going to have to run between the tackles. It's going to be very important. Their defense is, because of the size differential in the offensive line, they're going to have to control the line of scrimmage defensively.
All right, we told you already about how bad the weather is. What does that mean then for these respective football teams? Well, it means that the little guys are probably going to be called on in a big way tonight. Who are we talking about? We're talking about the place kickers, Andre LaFleur.
This guy is really kicking the ball well, Jim. Ranked number 12th in the nation. He's having a tremendous year. Kicked 4 field goals. Reed Morton, another guy Brad Scott has a lot of confidence in, kicked a 48-yarder.
Well, I called the one against Kentucky where he hit the upright, hit the crossbar, hit the upright again, and then it finally fell over for 3 points. So we really think that the place kickers, particularly with the poor weather conditions tonight, will be very, very important in how tonight's game unfolds. LSU, by the way, won the coin toss, and they have deferred. As you take a look at Howard right here, loosening up on the sidelines. And of course, now they've had 2 weeks to simmer. He had 3 interceptions returned for touchdowns at Auburn.
I tell you, when that happens, a coach has got to be wondering what's going on. We're in Auburn. We're beating the Auburn Tigers, a team that has been undefeated. What's going on here?
They just made an announcement here in the stadium, which is kind of comical. No umbrellas in the stadium.
There's going to be some unhappy folks about that one. I can see them already. They're mad.
We're just about ready to get this one underway. LSU will kick off.
And South Carolina, of course, to receive. Brendan Bennett is there.
Interesting move by Curly Hallman here to defer the kick.
On the defer?
Yeah, I think so. I think South Carolina's been a little slow starting this year.
All right, so it's Bennett and Richardson who are back. And this one will be Reggie Richardson at the 5-yard line, trying to get to the outside. Loads one tackler and moves out past the 20, maybe to the 23-yard line. It's an 18-yard kickoff return, and that is where Steve Tannehill and company will begin their first offensive series. And now the starting lineups. We've talked about Tannehill. We've talked about Bennett. We have spoken a little bit about Pritchard, Cates Bridges, and Boomer Foster, rounding out the backs and receivers. And Vincent Dinkins anchoring that center position now as he is back and healthy from that injury.
I think there's obviously a big key tonight on the offensive line. They've got to get some protection for Steve Tannehill.
All right, they look out of the eye, and quickly Tannehill throws out of it, but he's not going to be much there. In fact, they're going to lose yardage on the play. A nice play by Torrey James of LSU as he smelled it and came up from his defensive spot to make the play. What a big Miller, the big left tackle, is the star of that defensive line right there from LSU. We've already told you about Mike Calais and what a factor he could be in the secondary. And on the next play from scrimmage, the Gamecocks cannot connect again. Rodney Young with a defensive play there for LSU.
Here, this is going to be a big situation, a big opportunity for South Carolina. Last week, they were really slow converting their third downs. You've got an excellent LSU defense that's holding the other teams to 25% third down conversion rate. South Carolina is going to have to convert early here.
So it's third down and 14. Tannehill under pressure, eludes the rush, 5-4 time, lets it go. The pass is caught, but it's not even going to get back to the original line of scrimmage. It was completed to Bennett, but Alan Stansberry was there to knock him down. And the LSU Tiger defense hears it from the fans in attendance tonight.
Something Coach Phil Bennett, the defensive coordinator from LSU, said: this year we want to be an attacking defense. We want to put pressure on people, and that's exactly what they're doing here early.
We spoke to Derwin Jeffcoat prior to the start of tonight's game. We ran into him in the lobby of the hotel. He said, I hope I'm not out there a lot. Here he is, three and out for the Gamecocks. And he nails it. And it's Eddie Kennison who will make the play at the 35-yard line. And look out, he's got some running room as he breaks it to the outside. Up across midfield, past the 45, knocked down at the 42-yard line. A 19-yard return off of a 42-yard kick that time by Jeffcoat.
This is an area of concern for the South Carolina Gamecocks. Last week they gave up several big plays in the return game. Brad Scott made an interesting comment about their guys getting out of their lanes. He said, if I were to throw a hand grenade out there, I'd probably kill the whole team.
As you look at the LSU offensive line, and it is a good one. And this is our first opportunity to take a look at Jamie Howard. As the Tigers operate out of the eye, and the handoff with some running room going through there is Jermaine Sharp.
Stacy Evans.
Stacy Evans with the tackle there for South Carolina. We've already called Evans' name and talked about him. David Turnipseed is going to have to come up big in this game also.
These guys are obviously, you're going to see what LSU is already trying to do, run inside.
Hank Campbell in the middle, suffering from a little bit of the effects of a mild sprain that he got during practice this past week in the ankle. Breakaway run again, it's Sharp, and he's got enough yardage for the first down. Gain of 10 on the play.
LSU really working the perimeter running game here tonight. If they can do that, if they can run inside and they can get to the edge like this, they've really got some speed. Look at the great block there. These guys are really working hard downfield. You've got linemen working downfield to try to get secondary blocks. It's really going to be really help their running game tremendously.
So with the first down and the ball at the 30. Again, Sharp with some running room. Down near the 25. We'll see where they stop his forward progress, just shy of the 25-yard line, so he'll get the 5-yard gain.
That's a big game, but I tell you, as a defensive coach, you got to like what you see here when you get 8, 9 defensive hats on the ball. That ball, as wet as it is tonight, it's going to come loose. There again, you can't let a guy run for 5 yards of carry every time he gets the ball.
David Turnipseed, one of the first Gamecocks to get the Sharp. Now out of the single back formation. Howard inside handoff again. It's Sharp trying to bring it to the outside. Spins away from a tackler and is finally brought down at the 15-yard line. Another 10-yard run by Jermaine Sharp.
This guy, what a heck of a talent this guy is. Really quick.
Well, now look at the hole out right there that he has to run through.
The offensive line is doing a tremendous job, and you see how wet it is. Chris Abrams comes over there, tries to arm tackle this guy, can't hold on to him.
4 rushes and 27 yards already for Jermaine Sharp. LSU's opening offensive drive of the game. From the 15-yard line, again it's Sharp. Getting hemmed in a little bit, but then putting his head down and driving forward for about a pickup of 3 or 4.
I tell you, they're going to keep going to this running game until South Carolina stops it. See them going right back to the same play every time. They're still running to their left. You can see they're running basically a two tight end offense here. They've kind of gone a little bit more conservative tonight, figuring we've already got to run the football because of the weather. Let's bring two tight ends in the game. Let's see if we can do it, see if South Carolina can stop us.
Well, they've been running behind offensive tackle Sean Wells. Big number 74. This time they try the other side. Not as much running room that time. Again, it is Sharp, who's really getting a workout. He's carried 6 carries now for 33 yards.
Good play by Ronnie Smith coming up on the outside. Another big guy that South Carolina really rallies around, and Ronnie Smith making great plays from his linebacker position.
You can see the effects of the weather on our camera with that particular shot. As they say in the television business, it's a beauty shot. All right, the ball at the 11-yard line. 3rd and 3 now for LSU. They operate out of the eye. And Howard's first pass is going to be caught for a touchdown.
What a pass.
Eddie Kennison with the reception, just a down and out pattern, an 11-yard touchdown reception for Kennison, and just like that, LSU on the board with 6.
You have a guy, Eddie Kennison, doing it all. 3rd in the nation in punt returns. Here he is running a simple, we call red area corner route. It's just designed to do this in this 2-deep coverage. The short amount of space here that the DBs have got to cover, they just run away from the safety who's covering that deep half.
And here is LaFleur to tack on the extra point. He's perfect. And with 10:08 to go in the first quarter of play, it's 7-0 LSU. Well, I suppose if you're the road team, and it's not just South Carolina, but any road team, when you come down to play at this particular stadium, the thing you don't want to have happen is have the Tigers score on their first possession.
Absolutely. What a momentum builder. This is just a tremendous play here. Jamie Howard, you can't get a better pass than this. And really, you've got pretty good coverage there by the safety. You get a pass like that, there's just nothing you can do. Outstanding play by Jamie Howard and Eddie Kennison.
And that was their only pass of that drive.
Absolutely. They came out and did something that's very uncharacteristic for the LSU Tigers. Run the football. 2 tight ends. Inside running. Perimeter running. An outstanding job. Something South Carolina obviously had a little trouble with against Kentucky last week. The inside running game. They're going to have to control that tonight, because I guarantee you Kentucky's LSU is going to come right back with it.
Well, we talked a little bit about the disaster against Auburn. And I think if anybody thought there would still be some effects of what took place 2 weeks ago, I think that question's already been answered.
I think that's disappeared.
Set to get this one again underway. And this kick is bombed all the way out of the end zone. And that was Wade Ritchie, number 16, who handles the long kicking for LSU, and he got all of that one. And on the drive, it took him 3 minutes, or 3 minutes and 11 seconds, seven plays, 42 yards, and the only pass play was Jamie Howard to Kennison, 11 yards, and this touchdown.
That was just a picture-perfect drive there for the LSU Tigers. Running the ball, running the ball, made him down there in a crucial third down situation, come up with a great pass from Jamie Howard.
All right, so Tannehill and company back out on the field. And they will operate out of the eye. Bennett, the ball carrier, looking for some running room, and he's tripped up right at the 20-yard line.
This LSU defensive line is really holding their own tonight.
That's Gabe Northern right there, who is the guy who submarined on the play and got enough of Bennett's legs to bring him down.
There you go. You see him. He keeps fighting. Here he is. He's controlling the tackle. He just keeps playing, sticks his hand up. What a great play.
So no gain on the play. Steve Tannehill operates out of the shotgun. Looking for his man. Got it near the 25-yard line and finally forced out of bounds. Torrey James defensively there for LSU. And the catch there by Monty Means. By the way, I was going to tell you that Means had two touchdown receptions in the game against Kentucky.
Yeah, both in the second half. One of them a 50-yarder. Big play, really broke the game open. This is what South Carolina is going to have to be able to do tonight, is throw the football.
You want to see them go with a controlled passing game because of the weather. You want to go short as they go inside handoff here to Pritchard, trying to get enough yardage for the first down, but he's going to be short. Stansberry, Alan Stansberry, the first man to get him for the Tigers.
Interesting call from Brad Scott here.
Well, he's going to have to kick it.
I think a really smart call, though, from Brad Scott. These guys are backing up, playing the pass. It's third and five or six. I think he did a smart thing here. Stanley Pritchard makes a great run, almost gets a first down.
So Eddie Kennison and the fans begin to scream, Eddie, Eddie. He already has one touchdown in this game. And Derwin Jeffcoat is back at his own 15-yard line. Good snap from center. Plenty of time to get the kick underway. And Kennison is going to have some room to run as he breaks a couple of more tackles. One man to beat, and he might have gone the distance. 36-yard punt. More of a line drive punt that time. Exactly what you don't want to have happen. And a 15-yard return that time by Kennison, and they will mark it at midfield.
This guy is excited.
He's dangerous.
He really is, and it was a real area need for the Gamecocks coming off the win against Kentucky last week. Something they've really worked hard at this week is their punt and kickoff coverage teams.
First and 10 for the Bayou Bengals at midfield. And Howard again with the pump fake. Now everything's going to be blown dead.
Interesting. South Carolina going with the three-man rush here. Something I don't think they've done in the past or up to this point. Something that could really pose a little problem for Jamie Howard. I don't think he was looking for the three-man rush.
All right, so on the penalty, they'll mark it back 5 yards and move it to the 45, so it'll be first and 15 from the 45-yard line. Jamie Howard showing shotgun formation. First time we've seen it tonight, the inside handoff is sharp again with some running room. And then turnip seed, knifes in and gets his arms out just in time to knock Sharp down as he got maybe to the 46-yard line or maybe the 47-yard line.
South Carolina back with a four-man rush now. It looks like they might try to mix things up a little bit, keep LSU off balance.
Well, they had to change something. It was too easy for LSU that first drive.
Absolutely, and I'm surprised that LSU has come back out and spread themselves out again.
Pretty impressive numbers for Sharp so far this season. Again, out of the shotgun, Howard under pressure. Has to do it himself. Breaks a couple of tackles. Knocked down as he crosses the 45 in South Carolina territory. Aubie Brooks there for the Gamecocks with the tackle.
She saw Chris Rump coming off the corner untouched.
Right there.
What a great play by Jamie Howard to get anything out of this.
Well, it was an 8-yard scramble that time by the quarterback, Howard.
He's lucky he didn't end up in the second row.
It'll be 3rd and 3 from the 44. Long count. He's going to put the ball in the air under pressure. And the officials now throw the flag and stop the play.
South Carolina coming with the blitz again.
It's like they may have taken too much time. That was an illegal procedure penalty. They had a player moving before the snap of the football. Oh, there it is right there, 79. That's Marcus Price as he came out of his three-point stance a little too soon. And the Tigers have been very lax on third down efficiency, right around about 25%. Now it's 3rd and 9. Out of the shotgun, they try to run a little shovel pass, and that one is going absolutely nowhere. Robert Toomer caught the pass and then immediately was decked by Aubrey Brooks.
What a great play by Aubrey Brooks. He said, I'm not getting fooled by anything on this play. And this is what you want to see as a defensive coordinator. A guy who sits in there and keys well. Here you go, watch him. He's keeping his man. He's watching this guy all the way. Great play.
That's a heads-up play that time by Brooks, coming from his linebacker position. Chad Kessler getting ready to kick this one away. His first punt of the night. Kate yells for the fair catch and makes it at the 14-yard line. And that is where South Carolina will take over again. A 35-yard punt. And on the fair catch, no return.
Once again, South Carolina coming up with poor field position. They've had bad field position all night. They really need to get a break here so they can get the ball across the 50. They need a play, something. Defense is going to have to make a play. Special teams, they obviously are not going to have as much success driving the length of the field.
All right, while we've got a moment, we want to remind you that the announcers for this game have been contracted for and approved by Video Seat and Host Communications. Any use, rebroadcast, or other transmission of this game without the written consent of Video Seat and Host Communications is prohibited. Brandon Bennett on that carry. And to be perfectly honest with you, Brad, I think they're going to have to really utilize Bennett and Pritchard tonight.
Absolutely. And here South Carolina's going with a hurry-up, fast-break offense.
I think that's a good change.
Yeah, trying to catch the LSU Tigers off guard.
Straight ahead running. This time it's Pritchard. He's got enough yardage for the first down and more as he slams up near the 30-yard line. An 11-yard gallop that time by Pritchard. Mike Walker was there to bring him down for LSU.
What a great run by Stanley Pritchard. And here you see, this is exactly why this hurry-up offense is effective. Look at LSU. They look like they don't know what they're doing right now. They're off guard. They don't really know who's in the ball game. This is really, I think, an excellent move by Brad Scott.
Tannehill under center. They shift into the I formation. Tannehill play action. And they try to dump a little screen, but it was all messed up that time. And the reason? James Gilliard was right in the middle of everything.
The pressure on that play just killed it, just like you said. James Gilliard coming in there, getting pressure, making Steve Tannehill really not think about where he's throwing the football, not sitting, holding, looking for where his receiver is. There you see Stanley Pritchard off in the background. He gets held up. Great play by LSU.
Mike Calais also was the guy who was putting the heat upon Tannehill. One is going absolutely nowhere.
You know, something here that is almost football 101. When you get in a second and long situation, draws and screens almost all the time. An outstanding job here by Phil Bennett, the defensive coordinator from LSU, looking for the draw or screen. They bring 5 men up on the line of scrimmage, get a 7-man front against a 4-wide look. Great play.
That was Mike Riddick, by the way, who was the ball carrier, and he absolutely didn't have any room to run. All right, third and long now. Tannehill swings it out to Reddick. Reddick trying to break a couple tackles, and he is not going to get up to the sticks. He was met head-on by Rodney Young, who said hello and then goodbye.
Jim, I love to see this right here.
I know you do.
Guys coming out here and just meeting face mask to face mask. Right now, the LSU Tigers are coming up. They're showing blitz. They're dropping out of it. And the guys are just, they're making South Carolina run little dump-off patterns on third down. Just what you want to do. Shows you the importance of getting the ball downfield on first and second down.
Oh, being that stud muffin that you are as a defensive back, I know you had to love it. Boo, Jeffcoat bangs this one into the wind. Here's Kennison at about the 28-yard line. Trying to break through the defensive white line there of South Carolina. A punt of 42 yards and a return of 7.
Great job.
The coverage
here
that time was much better.
Much better, much better. You see the guys coming down, covering in their lanes. Excellent job.
Well, poor Todd Ellis is down there on the sidelines, and he's probably, if he's smart, undercover someplace. And we're going to hear from Todd in just a little bit. The rain, it looks like, has let up some. It really came down hard just before airtime. Probably hanging out the boat. This is Sharp with running room to the outside, breaks a couple of tackles, crosses midfield. Jermaine Sharp again, another spectacular offensive run. Chris Abrams is the man that finally pushed him out of bounds for South Carolina.
Big importance in the running game here. You've got to have containment. The tight end is able to hook the defensive end here. A great block by the LSU receiver. And then you come up and you see again how important it is to stop guys when you have a chance. Missed tackles are going to kill you.
Sharp has carried the ball 8 times for 50 yards. Howard now checking off at the line of scrimmage. Got the throw. Oh, it hit his man right in the face. That was Eric Smith. And obviously Smith didn't quite get that check off.
Nice timing route though by the LSU Tigers. Jamie Howard, a nice throw. If you're a receiver, I really believe you've got to come down with that ball. They get a nice play by the defensive secondary. Coming up, not getting fooled by anything.
All right, a penalty. There was motion on the offensive line. So they penalize LSU 5 yards. And they blew that play dead. So it's still first down, 15 for a first down. The ball resting at the 46-yard line. Again, it's Sharp with running room right up the middle. Stumbles as he crosses midfield. Finally goes down at the 47.
The offensive line doing a tremendous job here opening up holes. And again, when you have a penalty on first down, or you get no yardage, look for draws and screens. The idea behind this is that you're going to get half the distance back that you lost. So the teams are going to try to do that, get back into a second and long situation where they can eventually end up third and short.
All right, it's second and 8 right now as we count down to the 2:20 mark here in the first quarter. It's 7-0 if you've just joined us in favor of LSU. Busted play, and Howard makes something happen out of it. All right, he crossed 45, knocked down at the 44-yard line. Let's go down now to the sidelines, and he's hanging out with his rubber duck. Here's Todd Ellis.
Boy, special teams are crucial every night, but tonight especially. USC having a bad happening already. Derek Gregory, their deep snapper, is either separated or has a stinger in his shoulder. He's out of the ball game right now going into the locker room. Something about that first quarter. Jamie Howard got a lot of confidence on that first drive, something Carolina could not have happened. Back upstairs, guys.
All right, Todd, thanks very much. Come harder now, and the fumble, and it's loose, and it is going to be recovered by South Carolina. A big time fumble recovery by Aubrey Brooks, and it couldn't come at a better time for the Gamecocks because LSU was moving the football. And yes, there are Gamecock fans in attendance. More than 5,000 have made the trip here to LSU.
Big play here by South Carolina. They're coming with a 2-man blitz. They're really leaving all their secondary out to dry. They put them in a tough position, having to cover 4 wide receivers. When you can do that, come up with a sack, you're going to have success like this all night. And there again, you're going to see the weather come into play just like it has here.
And we talked about LSU's propensity to turn the ball over. Look how many times they did it 2 weeks ago against Auburn. Tannehill out of the ball game. Blake Williamson is in, and the handoff is straight ahead running. Stanley Pritchard straight up the middle, crossing midfield, and finally brought down at about the 37-yard line. A gain of 18 on the play.
Watch the offensive line here. Nice trap block. What a fantastic run here. Now you can really see the strength of Stanley Pritchard. He's got his head down, his knees pumping, a la Roger Craig. It's going to take more than one guy to bring this guy down at the point of contact.
And you can see now how much more the rain is falling. Handoff, Brandon Bennett crosses the 35, knocked down maybe at the 34, maybe the 33. James Gilliard with the tackle that time for LSU.
South Carolina offensive line is really controlling the line of scrimmage here. If they keep this up, they're going to have a lot of success tonight.
At game time, the temperature was 73, but it is dropping rapidly here. And the handoff that time, and not too much running room for Pritchard.
Great job by the LSU defense. There again, looking for run.
Now Rodney Young came up from his linebacker spot that time to bring him down.
And Stansberry, here the Devils.
Blake Williamson in relief of Tannehill, and you get an indication of how bad it's raining. They had a tropical depression in the Gulf of Mexico, and it has moved on shore.
Moved here within Tiger Stadium.
Thanks a lot. And now the officials are going to stop play. As the quarter comes to a close, and at the end of one period, it is 7-0 LSU, and we're playing in a monsoon.
Yeah, this is the tropical depression right
yes,
here.
Yes, it is. It's right on top of us. He does look bad down there, doesn't he?
Kind of looks a little wet. That's all right. I'm used to playing in the rain.
I know you are.
In the Mid-Atlantic, you get plenty of these.
All right,
showers.
Fans. Carolina calls Thursday night, 7 o'clock. You want to check your local listings for your station in your area. Again, that's Carolina calls. It's Thursday night. At 7 o'clock, check your local listings or the station in your area carrying that program. Well, the fans are hearty here, I'll tell you that.
I tell you, they're few in numbers, but big in heart. They're making a lot of noise.
To be perfectly honest with you, I'm truly impressed with how many have shown up in weather like this.
Absolutely, and this is why teams really don't like to come here and play. You get people who really love the game of football follow the LSU Tigers. They make for a hostile environment.
Third and six, the ball at the 33-yard line. They're going to try, of course, to keep it as dry as they possibly can. In the first quarter, LSU rushed the football for 66 yards. The Gamecocks for 20. Ten yards passing for LSU, five for the Gamecocks. A total of 76 yards of offense for LSU and 25 yards offense for the Gamecocks in the first period of play. All right, we get ready now to begin the second quarter. Williamson operating now out of the shotgun, throws it high in the air. He's got his man! It's going to be caught and finally dragged out of bounds at about the 3 or 4 yard line. Ivory Hilliard makes a game, or rather a touchdown saving play on that 28-yard reception to Toby Cates.
What an outstanding play here and a big call. You think with all this weather, you're going to get a run, but no, they come back with a pass. Here you catch the LSU Tigers in a two-deep zone. Same thing LSU did to South Carolina. Let's run a little hitch by the outside guy in a corner, run away from the safety. What a great play.
Straight ahead running, not too much there. Somebody lost his helmet. It's rolled all the way out of the end zone.
Now there's some hitting going on out there.
Oh, boy.
I tell you, South Carolina trying to run into a nine-man front here. LSU putting everybody but the equipment managers up there on the line of scrimmage.
It was Randy Wheeler who had to go grab his hat. It literally got blown away. And we told you the fans are hardy here. South Carolina now trying to push it into the end zone and tie this game up. Pritchard is the up man, but the pass goes to Bennett, who throws it into the end zone. It's going to be caught for the score by Williamson, the quarterback. A little trick play.
They told us to look for something fishy. I tell you,
there it is.
Oh, what a great play, and what a gutsy call by Brad Scott. Down on the goal line, and really, if you're the LSU Tigers in this situation, you might have to be thinking pass a little bit. South Carolina's got something, a couple plays to throw away, but I tell you what, they caught me off guard. I wasn't looking for anything like that. What a great play.
Well, I'm telling you, those are the kind you use when you're in the kids playing in the street. And you do that little flip off to the back, and then the quarterback takes off and becomes the wide receiver. It works perfectly. And South Carolina now within a point and a chance to tie the game. With the extra point, they bobble the snap. And Reed Morton is going to be thrown down hard. Northern was the first guy there for LSU. And apparently Morton is okay. So now it's still a one-point lead for LSU at 7-6.
Let's take another look at this. What a great, with a wet ball and everything, nobody'd ever think you got a big old fullback, big tailback, I mean, making a pass like this. I'm just wondering why they never did that when I was a quarterback. Try to get
maybe,
to do it.
Maybe they were sending you a message that
yeah,
your hands weren't
right.
That good.
That's why I ended up playing defense.
So Blake Williamson makes the touchdown grab, and we have a one-point game at 14:03 here in the second quarter. It's LSU 7 and South Carolina 6.
Something Brad Scott said before the game is that we're going to have to stay with the passing game. We're going to have to be able to throw the ball regardless of the weather conditions tonight to beat LSU. Here you see some big, big plays in the passing game. It's making all the difference.
Well, they indicated to us that they were going to try, obviously, to keep the football as dry as they possibly could. Maybe they had brought in a dry ball right at that particular time because the pass was right on the money. He just lofted it up in the air and just let Williamson run underneath him. Now, here's Mr. Dangerous, Kennison. Well, there's some serious big-time hits going on right now.
And these guys are really getting after it. Here you're seeing a big momentum swing in the ball game right here. South Carolina starting to get pumped up. You can see them on the sidelines. Special teams, there's a very, very big emphasis in practice this week on special teams.
And on the scoring drive, Gamecock scoring, five plays, 54 yards, took them 226, and the three-yard pass from the tailback, Bennett, to the quarterback, Williamson. Sounds strange when you say it like that.
That'll be on everybody's highlight.
Oh, there. It'll make it. Oh, Sharp with lots of running room, straight ahead, all the way up near the 45, as he may have touched at the 44-yard line, 14 yards on the carry.
This is a scary sight when a guy comes running through untouched like that. You see a great block here by the tackle, by the guard and center. Actually, your middle linebacker just goes the wrong way. Huge hole.
Chris Abrams there to bring him down for the Gamecocks. They operate from the 43-yard line again. It's Sharp, and this time knocked down at the 45 as he gets stacked up.
Got a flag on the play. Looks like a late hit.
Now we'll wait for the officials to sort it out here. Reggie Richardson was there defensively for South Carolina.
Looked like a late hit to me.
All right, here it is.
Dead ball, personal foul.
You called it. It is the late hit, the personal foul call.
Well, it looks like they're not going to let him play tonight. I tell you, that didn't look that bad to me.
All right, you old defensive back. Let's see if it's a late hit or not. He's down, and there. Oh, that's what it is.
Yeah.
It's the smash to the face.
Yeah. Yeah. You got to be. You can't do that. You got to be a little smarter than that. I'm not saying it's wrong. I'm just saying you got to be smarter than that.
They run out of the eye, and you know who has got it again. Jermaine Sharp. And this time, the Gamecock defense does a little better job of getting to him.
I'd really be surprised if the LSU Tigers have a tremendous amount of success in the perimeter running game like this. I think one of the real strengths of the South Carolina defense is their athletic ability and their speed. These guys really get to the football.
So they can go sideline to sideline pretty well. They are more vulnerable with straight ahead running.
I think absolutely inside. They're outmanned by an average of 30 pounds a player up front.
Again, Sharp, and nowhere to run. And he bounces outside, and now there's nobody in front of him. And no one is going to catch him. Sharp is going to go the distance. It's a 36-yard touchdown run.
What a wild play that was. Can you believe that? All the way up in a pile like that. Reminiscent of Emmitt Smith coming out of there, Dallas Cowboys.
He had absolutely nowhere to go. They had him all bottled up right here.
Ronnie Smith thinks he has him, tackles the wrong guy.
And then once he breaks away, there aren't any Gamecock defenders staying back, of course. And he's in for six.
Shows a lot of vision on the part of the young man.
LaFleur's kick is up and good, and now it is 14-6 LSU.
I tell you, this is the battle of big plays tonight. And I tell you, we've got our share of funky plays tonight.
Well, we are already two now that'll make most highlight reels around the country.
Absolutely. Look at this, they've got him. Ronnie Smith has got his hands on him. He just can't pull him down. Outstanding vision. Jermaine Sharp just keeps pumping. He keeps his eyes open. Hey, if I'm not down yet, I'm not stopping.
That's it. I think he's got pretty good strength, too, because a couple of players had a hold of him, but he just pulled away and took off then around the corner.
Absolutely. And Ronnie Smith is a big guy here.
See, they're talking about it right now on the sidelines. Turnip seed. And Washington right there trying to figure out what happened.
I know exactly what he's saying. He's going, what in the world happened? This guy is already, you see Jermaine Sharp break several tackles tonight. Nobody's going to bring this guy down. Really strong runner.
Wade Ritchie again will handle the kickoff duties for LSU. And with 12:22 remaining in the second period of play, it is 14-6. The Tigers leading the Gamecocks. Last time Ritchie kicked it, he kicked it out of the end zone. And this time, it's going to be short and an opportunity for the run back as Bennett catches it. And he's going to be stopped up, breaks away from a couple of LSU tacklers, crosses the 20, knocked down at the 21. A gain of 18 on the kickoff return. And Jimmy Taylor was the man that brought him down. Well, for LSU, four plays, they go 72 yards. It only took them a minute 34. And, of course, Jermaine Sharp with that brilliant 36-yard run.
Absolutely brilliant. And I know that that's something that Wally Burnham, the defensive coordinator of the South Carolina Gamecocks, talked about all week. The big play. Let's don't give up the big play. Bend but don't break. We'll go after him. Good things are going to happen to us.
Steve Tannehill back in now at quarterback for South Carolina. Bennett. Looking for some running room, not too much there. May have gotten a couple yards. Chuck Wiley, number 55 for LSU, on the tackle.
I tell you, the LSU defensive line is really playing well in these situations. They're lining up, they're thinking run all the way. They're calling these plays almost like they know them. They're getting in there, getting great penetration in this inside running game.
Now Bennett's going to have to get out of there, even though his shoe is, had come off. And don't tell me Tannehill's going to have to waste a timeout. He's going to argue, yeah, he's going to have to waste the timeout. Generally, the officials will let it stop for just a few seconds while the guy tries to get his shoe on, but then they have to start the clock again, and that's exactly what happened. But Bennett couldn't get his shoe on quick enough.
Yeah, this could really hurt South Carolina, too, having to take an early timeout like this in a tight ball game. I know Brad Scott wants to hold on to those timeouts for a two-minute hurry-up situation. here again. You got a wild situation, and they probably did the right thing.
There was some talk. You see Frederick right there. There was some talk that we might see Kurt Frederick, a wide receiver, in some sort of trick play.
Yeah.
Maybe an end around and then have him pull up and throw the football. He is a former quarterback.
Absolutely. And as a defensive player, that's something we always look for. We always know the guys who have been quarterbacks previously in their career, because at some point in time in this season, that's going to come up. Any guy just like Brandon Bennett, some point in time this season, it's going to happen. You got to be prepared for that. And you're chasing ghosts a lot of times, but you got to be prepared.
So Frederick goes to the far side. To the near side is Monty Means, and Tannehill will operate out of the shotgun. Tannehill shovel pass. Pritchard caught it and then stumbled and went down immediately.
South Carolina thinking, I mean, the LSU Tigers thinking pass here, showing an eight-man front, everybody up in the gap, showing blitz, backing out, looking for the pass. This play could have really been big for South Carolina, but to get an outstanding play, again, outstanding penetration by the Tiger defense.
Third and nine now for the Gamecocks. Tannehill, lots of time. Got hit from behind, the ball is loose. Now the officials rule incomplete pass. They rule that his arm was indeed in forward motion. Gabe Northern was the guy who came from behind to get Tannehill and forced the miscue.
LSU doing a tremendous job. Look at this. Their secondary is something we always say. Great coverage causes sacks. They're covering up everybody out there. There's not anybody open. You get great pressure inside. This is something that Brad Scott's offense has got to have to do. Puts a premium on protection.
And you can definitely see that his arm was indeed coming forward. And Jeffcoat, we'll see where the official walks, kicks it out of bounds. He's still walking up that sideline, still going, and now finally pulls up at about the 44-yard line and 20-yard punt for Jeffcoat.
Play for South Carolina. There again, you're going to see how hard it's going to be to kick the football tonight. I have all ideas that they're really trying to kick away from Eddie Kinnison.
Well, I would think
probably
so, yeah.
Kick away from him too.
Yeah, they don't want him handling the football. If they can absolutely avoid that, they'd be real pleased. In the meantime, Jamie Howard under center. Carrying the football, number 36 is Robert Tuber, as they give Sharp a little bit of a rest.
I tell you, he's deserved it.
You think so, huh?
Absolutely. This guy's had a heck of a night tonight.
Well, he's got over 100 yards, and we still have more than 10 minutes to play in the first half. So Tuber stays lined up as the lone setback. Kennison is in the slot to the near side. He has caught a touchdown pass. They hand it off. Tuber trying to get outside. Crosses the 40. Cannot get to the 35 as he's hit and dropped at the 36-yard line.
I really believe that LSU is running into the real strength of the South Carolina defense here. You see it again. Watch him try to string it out. But here comes the strength of the South Carolina defense, being able to run.
Well,
really
there's Watkins and Richardson. Richardson right there.
And your secondary guys coming up making a great play from the corner.
Third and three at the 36. This time operating out of the eye. Again, Tuber, lots of running room, and now the flags fly, and they're going to blow this one, and the play will not count. Well, that's a couple of times now that we've seen LSU have difficulty with the flags flying before the play gets started. And here comes the announcement.
Dead ball, illegal procedure, false start.
And you see again another procedure
penalty
against LSU.
Here we go. You see the right tackle just hitch a little bit. There he goes right there. Sounds like he may be having trouble determining what the snap count is tonight. South Carolina gets up the field very well on defense. They might be alternating their snap count a little bit to try to throw them off guard.
Marcus Price, second time he's been flagged. Now operating out of the shotgun. They want to go with a deep ball. Got a man, but they can't catch up to it. Pass was intended that time for number 87, Brett Besch.
This is something you can look for almost automatically. Well, in fact, it is an automatic call. Here you see South Carolina coming up with a five-man rush, a blitz. Corners are pressing. What do they do every time they get a blitz and the corners are pressing? They throw the fade every time. You can count on it.
And Reggie Richardson with good coverage that time for South Carolina. Toby Cates is back to receive the punt. Chad Kessler standing at his own 45-yard line. And it's a high punt that Cates will make the fair catch call and come up with a grab. And at the 13, that is where South Carolina will begin. A 29-yard punt that time for Chad Kessler.
South Carolina is going to start another drive. Bad field position. They just cannot get any good field position tonight. They're going to have to come up with another big play.
Under 9 minutes left in the second quarter as we move toward halftime. Jim Brinson, Brad Edwards with you. We are here at LSU in the midst of a downpour. But it's been a pretty good football game thus far. Not too much running room that time. Mike Sutton, the first LSU Tiger to make the hit.
Mike Sutton coming up here, just really sticking his nose in there. What a big kid.
Well, you know, they're really going to key on Brandon Bennett. There's no question about that.
Absolutely.
Steve Tannehill working without the benefit of the huddle. They try to go a little hurry up here. And out of the shotgun. Tannehill with time. Swings it out to Bennett. Running room on the near sideline. Nice cutback. Drags the tackler with him up to the 20-yard line. That was Pat Rogers who was hanging on that time to finally bring Bennett down. It's a gain of six.
This guy is really something. I tell you, he continually impresses me. Brandon Bennett catches the ball, blocks. He throws the ball.
Yeah, we know that.
He runs the ball. He's a guy who can do it all. Look for a big future from this guy.
Third and three at the 20. Tannehill with time, got his man, and it is close to the necessary yardage for the first down. It's just going to be one of those left foot, right foot marks. Kurt Frederick with the reception. James was there for LSU, and they do indeed say he got the first down. They're not going to measure.
What a good play here. You see LSU is blitzing. They're manned up. They know the blitz breakoff is the quick slant. But here you got a big guy, Kurt Frederick, just gets his body in there. The ball's got to go through him in order for the receiver to make a play.
Again, Tannehill with time. Got his man at the 35-yard line.
Now this is
Niccolo with the reception.
This is the real strength of this South Carolina offense, the fast break offense here. Puts a premium on getting the ball downfield in the passing game. If they're able to do this, this is what they want to be able to do, move the ball downfield so they can open up their running game.
Now, Darrell Niccolo has real solid hands. He can make some tough catches for you, and he just made a good one there. Tannehill with the roll. This time it's Frederick who makes the sliding, diving catch at the 45-yard line. Coverage there by Rodney Young, but right now the Gamecocks moving the ball very effectively.
They really are, and I like this moving pocket, but what they've done is they've gone into this hurry-up situation with four wides. They've got LSU. They've got bad matchups out there. LSU hasn't been able to substitute.
Well, that's what the hurry up will do for you. Tannehill under some pressure, checks it off to Pritchard with running room, crosses the 50-yard line, and then rolls down to the 48. Rodney Young for LSU with the stop.
Brad Scott mixing it up now. Here's another look at this.
This is good by Tannehill.
Tannehill.
He looks one way and goes the other.
He does, and that's a great marker. I know as a defensive player, you're watching those eyes. You're seeing the eyes of the quarterback. You think he's going to take exactly where he's going to throw the football. You got a guy like Stanley Pritchard back there.
And the inside handoff to Pritchard that time didn't fool anybody. David Carmona right there with the stop for LSU. All right, let's quickly go down to the sidelines. Here's Todd. Todd.
Guys, obviously injuries are going to be key in this ball game. Boomer Foster now has an ankle injury. He's out. It doesn't seem to be slowing the Gamecocks down, but if these teams have to go primarily to the running game, that will be a very important key for the Gamecocks late in this ball game. Let's go back upstairs.
All right, Todd, you still look like a drowned rat down there. I don't think it's going to get much better.
I always say, better him than me.
Something about he wants to be in the booth here, Brad, if you're going down. Did I, I didn't tell you that.
I didn't
that wasn't that in your contract. Nice play of the drive coming up here now. And it's third and three. Tannehill. Nice little checkoff pattern, and I'm not sure if they're going to get it or not. The pass was caught by Marcus Robinson. But Rodney Young came up to make the play along with James Gilliard, and they are going to be short.
This shows you how hard it is to go the length of the field on a drive. The percentage-wise, where South Carolina started this drive on their own 15-yard line, the percentages go way down in terms of being able to go the length of the field and score.
And they punt it away, and Kennison will not be able to field this one, and a terrific kick that time by Jeff Cohn as the ball goes out of bounds at the 5-yard line. A 43-yard punt and obviously no return. That's exactly what he's hoping to do.
Absolutely. Keep it away from this guy. Kick to the corner. This is really going to prove to be a big play for South Carolina.
Now remember, fans, next South Carolina home game, you'll have the opportunity to pick up your copy of Kickoff Carolina Souvenir Program for only $4. That's your souvenir program, Kickoff Carolina, at the next home game against East Carolina. All right, Penn now with their backs to the wall is LSU. They run the football with Robert Toomer that time carrying.
Big play by South Carolina here. I know what they're thinking. They're thinking if we can just hold them down here, it's going to be points for us. I think they're ready for some points as well.
Yeah, you're probably right. The rain obviously has died down here a little bit. It is still quite breezy, but we're not in the deluge that we once were.
The depression's over the parking lot now.
Yeah, we'd like to thank, by the way, the parking attendants here for not letting us park very close to the truck and making us run in it. That was real nice of them.
We were destined to get wet.
We were. Toomer carries that one again. And Hank Campbell was right there to be the first Gamecock tackler in on the play. 14-6, LSU out in front of South Carolina. We've hit the four-minute mark as we near halftime.
This might be one of the biggest plays for South Carolina. They can hold them here, come back, get a decent return on the punt. Could mean points.
And Howard a little bit confused on where he was actually going to set up. Now gets underneath center. Out of the eye. Howard wants to throw it. Does so. It's going to be way short of his intended receiver. That was Shedrick Wilson. And he never had a chance to field one as the ball bounced a couple of feet in front of him. So the Gamecock defense does its job, exactly what they were hoping to do. They got the great placement on the punt, and now it's three and out for LSU, and they have to kick out of their own end zone.
Yeah, you couldn't have written a better script than this. Here you go, Jamie Howard, a little unsure to start with. You see a wet ball coming out there. That's a long throw. It's going to be hard to make those long throws to the out tonight.
Gamecocks have everybody on the line of scrimmage. They're coming after this one, and they cannot get a piece of it. As Kessler gets it out, Toby Cates at the 47, looking for some running room, crosses the 45 and makes headway down to the 44, maybe the 43-yard line. A punt of 40 and a 4-yard return. Eric Valentino was the tackler on the play for LSU.
South Carolina, you're doing a smart thing, getting real aggressive, going after a punt. The only problem is when you do that, you don't have any blockers.
Yeah, you're
if
right.
If they get the punt off, you're looking for a fair catch. They don't have anybody to block.
All right, Tannehill and company now come out, and they'll begin at the 43-yard line. They will run out of the eye. Play fake. Ooh, bobbled that time, but hanging on to the football is Corey Bridges. Actually, probably would have picked up some more yardage if he would not have bobbled that one.
Yeah, nice play on the hit screen. I like this play a lot. It really is a great misdirection play. Here you get your tackle coming down, working the edge of the screen. Just get a bobbled ball. I agree. I think he could have gotten a few more yards out of that thing without the bobble.
Brandon Bennett in motion. Here's Frederick. We told you that he could throw it, but he's not going to have the opportunity. Gabe Northern smelled something and closed in and shut the door on the trick play. A loss of 10 on the play.
Crushing play for South Carolina. Well, you called it here. They're going the same play to the opposite side. They set it up by running this play on the other side with just a little different look.